If you want website traffic from Google, you need to learn how to do basic keyword research for your blog. Contrary to some popular misunderstandings about blogging, blogging is not the process of opening up your webpage, jotting down some stream of consciousness thoughts, hitting publish, and being on your way. Blogging doesn't work like that, at least it doesn't anymore. In order to get website traffic from Google, you need to write about topics that you know people are searching for. You know that your website can be on page one of Google for. That's called ranking. After all, no one wants to spend hours pouring themselves into a magnificent blog post that no one will ever read because it will never show up on Google for that search term. The process of keyword research might sound really intimidating, and frankly, some of the tools are, but not the tool that you should use. The best affordable SEO tool is Keysearch. I'm going to walk you through how to use Keysearch for your blog, even if you're a beginner, to find keywords that you know you can rank for so that you know where to put your effort to actually show up on Google. To help make it easy, I also have a discount code and a checklist for you, so let's get into it. Hey everyone, Kayla here from Writing From Nowhere. Before getting into the screen share, I just want to touch on the basics. What are keywords? Keywords are the terms that people type into Google. Whenever you go to write your blog post, you're going to pick one keyword and focus on that as the topic of your blog post. There are two important types of keywords. There are short tail keywords and long tail keywords. Short tail keywords are keywords that are 1 to 2 words, and long tail is anything 3 or more words. Whenever you get into your keyword research software, you'll see that there are really high search volumes for certain short tail keywords, and it can be really tempting to target them. For example, let's say you're writing a blog post on the topic of fun facts about Maine Coon cats. Maine Coon cats are like huge house cats, and a fun fact, they can swim really well. Who knew? If you're writing a blog post on that topic, you would never want to target the keyword cats. That is a short tail keyword that might look really tempting because it has more than 3 million searches per month, but it will not bring people to your blog post on fun facts about Maine Coon cats because it is far too competitive. On page one of Google, you see Wikipedia, Cats the Musical, Cats the Movie, because Google doesn't have enough information based on one keyword to know exactly what people want. A one-word keyword is almost never that effective for bringing people to your website. You want to go after those long-tail keywords and only ever target one so that you don't confuse Google or readers. You want to be as specific as you can with your keyword so that your blog post gets on page one of Google. That's called ranking, as we talked about, and if you are not on page one of Google, you did not rank, and people will never really read it, because almost no one ever clicks through to page two of Google. It's the best place to bury a dead body, because no one will ever look there. You want to be specific so that you're on page one, and then the people who click through are getting answers to their question. Then they're more likely to stay on your website longer, read more, put in an inquiry about hiring your services, buy your product. The sweet spot with your keyword research is finding low competition keywords, but high search volume. Let's get into Keysearch so I can show you exactly what I'm talking about. So now I'm inside of Keysearch, and this is what the interface looks like. And Keysearch is a fantastic keyword research tool because it's affordable, it's less than $14 a month with a discount code, and it gives you a ton of powerful data. Now, there are other tools that provide more data and more numbers and everything, but if you're not prepared to use them, then it's not worth paying for. Let's look in here really quickly. You see cat. So this was my cat search from before. And there are two important things to look at here. You see here volume, and this is the estimated number of monthly searches, which we can see is more than 3 million. And we see the difficulty score. This is just called the score, but this refers to how difficult it is to get on page one of Google. And then this shows different search volumes. Interesting, I guess are people cold or lonely in December, January? Cat searches go up, but if you scroll down, you see these are the top 10 ranking posts on Google. Let's zoom in on the difficulty score here. So this is difficulty 66 and it's dark red. And if we look at the ranking pages on Google, we can see that these are also high domain authority and dark red and yellow sites here. So this is very competitive, but in order to be able to use the difficulty score to help you with your keyword research, you need to know how high you can target. So that's where you're gonna go over to your website. So I've pulled up my website here, writingfromnowhere.com. I'm gonna copy the URL, go back to Keysearch, and hit explore here up on the top bar. Enter your domain here, paste that in, and then leave this as entire domain. That's the default, and hit search. This is going to give you your score to target on a scale of 1 to 100, and it's also going to give you a color. So my domain can target anything under a 41, and this is relative. And then there's also a breakdown of your backlinks, keywords that you're ranking for, and some other information here, but you don't need to get into all of that to do effective keyword research. Now with my difficulty score, let's go back to the keyword research section of Keysearch and see what keywords I can rank for that have a high search volume. To get back to the keyword research area, I'm going to click on keyword research, and then the dropdown will say keyword research again. And let's say I'm writing a blog post on calligraphy. I'm going to type in the short tail keyword calligraphy here, hit search, and see what comes up. So we can see the general search trends here, and then the top 10 ranking posts on Google on the left. And on the right, we can see related keywords, suggestions, ideas that Keysearch has come up with. Now, since we are looking for always the lowest difficulty possible, let's say just because I have a 41 score to target, that doesn't mean that I can or should target everything within that range. That's still the highest reach of my competitive swing. So it's always still better to go lower in competition. So let's click here for score, and it's going to sort these from highest to lowest, and then we'll hit score again, and it is sorting from lowest to highest. And now you can see those color coding in action a little bit. So blue is the lightest. And if something, you can see here a difference of kind of like a faded green and then a more intense green. That just means that this score has not been updated in the last 30 days, and you can click to update it. Now this will change during seasonal searches or just during natural fluctuations. We see the happy blue and green searches here. So let's just scroll down. We get into those intermediate difficulty searches, and then down to red, and then that is where the difficulty score stopped in terms of the color coding, but you also see these blank ones, and you can go and check these manually. Another way to sort these searches here on the right is by volume. So in the same way, you click once and you see the low searches there, we click again and we see the high ones, and you can see these in order of how popular they are on Google. And you can also filter out. It's a really sneaky button. It's here on the left. It's almost invisible. But if you hit filter, let's say you don't even want to look at the searches below your difficulty score. You can enter your difficulty score there, and then you'll filter out those options that are out of your domain's reach. And you can also type in negative words. So a common keyword with calligraphy that we're seeing here is Arabic. And let's say I do not specialize in that type of calligraphy. So I'm going to add that as a negative. Not how you spell Arabic. A-R-A-B-I-C. There we go. And now let's also say I want anything above 50. So we have a negative keyword, volume, and score. Hit filter, and then you see those results. Let's close out the filter and go back over to the left-hand side of the screen here. And let's go back to just the calligraphy search and look again. So we saw that that search difficulty was 60, which was already really high. But let's just take this a little bit farther and look at who is ranking here on the side. So we see Wikipedia, Lettering Daily, Creative Market, Amazon, Merriam and Webster. These are massive domains, and we know that because a lot of these are, you know, household names. Those are just big brands that a small blog or a new blog can't compete with. And we can also see that reflected here in the DA, which stands for Domain Authority. And even further, you can look down over here at links, and you can see that some of these pages have tens of thousands of links pointing back to this page. These are all signs this is too competitive of a search. Looking at just this data, it could suggest that all of calligraphy is too competitive of a niche for you to rank for, but we know that that's not true because we saw the other data. So let's go back to our right-hand side of the screen and let's sort these by difficulty. And we see loads of keywords that Keysearch has found for us. Calligraphy services, basic calligraphy address, traditional store, and we can see the search volume here. And for example, this is a really great find in terms of a low difficulty, high volume keyword, basic calligraphy, with the volume, an estimated search volume of 3,600 searches a month, and difficulty 25 to target, which is a score that most blogs could target. Let's wrap up this tutorial with a list of keywords that we know we can rank for and we know that people are searching for. So let's go back up here to that filter and let's set a search volume of, let's say, a minimum of 200. And let's put our difficulty score in here. And now we're going to filter out these results. Now we've shaved off the top layer of those search results that we could never really rank for, and we have a list of dozens of keywords that people are searching for by the hundreds every month and that we know we can rank for thanks to the explore feature in our domain string.
If you have questions about Keysearch, feel free to drop them in the comments and I'll see if I can make a video to walk through those questions. And I also have a blog post that dives more into Keysearch. I'll put that in the description bar along with a link to my Keysearch checklist. The checklist goes beyond just the keyword research area that we were in today and shows you more areas of Keysearch for finding keywords, as well as how to find keywords based on what your competitors are ranking for. So there's a lot of opportunity out there for you. Thanks so much for watching and can't wait to see you next time.